Welcome back. We hope you're having success transitioning to a more sustainable lifestyle. Today, we're going to discuss with you some different examples of carbon footprints so we all understand their relationship to our lives. Whether it is a carbon or energy footprint, what do we mean by the life cycle? Some people describe it as cradle to grave. Essentially, the energy required for everything involved in that product's life. Taking the resources out of the ground, manufacturing or growing something, transporting it, refrigerating it if required, selling it in a bricks and mortar retail store or an online presence, usage of the product for the average life expectancy of it, and finally the disposal of it. Understanding the path that something takes throughout its life and appreciating some of the rarely thought about steps above is essential in finding the easiest ways to reduce your footprint. We mentioned earlier that products you purchase account for a third of your carbon footprint. Like energy, not all products are created equal. The carbon footprint of two different brands of the same product may be vastly different. We strive to keep you educated through using our app, which allows you to compare these products and then purchase the most environmentally responsible one. Purchasing products that are made from renewable energy, recycled material, or grown at a farmer's market and transported along a sustainable supply chain are the lowest producers of carbon. The produce you purchase has one of the largest disparities in the carbon footprint. This is due to the season, where you purchase from, and even how you store it. To ensure you minimize your carbon footprint, you can buy produce that is in season, visit your local farmer's market wherever possible, carry reusable bags and avoid prepackaged produce, and choose your online delivery wisely. When your produce is out of season, it means that it has traveled a longer distance to reach you and most likely required refrigeration to keep it fresh. Our app and website can give you a list of what is in season at your location. When buying from your local farmer's market, we all think of it as being organic and sustainably sourced. We should also understand that the produce was grown within 50 miles, which means big carbon savings over interstate and overseas grown produce. Paper or plastic bag? Neither option is ideal. Bringing and reusing your own bag is the best. It is true that disposable bags use much less energy to make, but think about how many times you purchase things in a year. 102 billion plastic bags were used in the USA last year. That equates to 310 per person. So even if your reusable bag only lasted for a year, you're already saving 50% of this carbon footprint. Online shopping is one of the largest growing areas in the grocery sector. The convenience suits modern life, but this convenience comes at a high cost. The packaging used to protect and keep produce cool increases the carbon footprint. To combat this, you can select the option that requires you to be home to receive the goods, as this usually reduces the packaging. Many grocery stores deliver your items in a reusable carry bag that they retrieve with the next delivery. When you head out to a restaurant, consider everything that goes into bringing you your meal. The food service industry has one of the highest building carbon footprints per square foot. Consider that, on average, the carbon footprint is 135 pounds of CO2 per square foot of restaurant space each year. So, depending on the amount of customers and how long you stay there, your visit equates to over a half pound of carbon emissions per hour. You have no control whether they have sourced sustainable or local produce, but many restaurants have been certified and won awards for such practices. Doing some prior research is becoming a lot easier. Ordering food online seems like a great way to cut down on your carbon footprint. By cooking bulk food for a large number of orders without the dining space, delivery does edge dining out with a lower footprint. However, due to the overabundance of packaging, the disposal of this waste makes this an unsustainable practice. The average carbon footprint for both delivered and dining-in meals are slightly higher, around 10%, than a home-cooked meal. This factor can increase up to 3 times if you are dining at a high-end restaurant. Some restaurants that are committed to sustainability can have the carbon footprint in comparison to a home-cooked meal. But remember, your transportation method is also important. A microwave is the most efficient use of your home cooking energy, followed by the stovetop, and the worst option is using an oven. Alternatives to your oven, such as slow cookers or pressure cookers and bread makers, are a far more efficient use of energy. We hope you've learned a few things today that will help your transition to a sustainable lifestyle. The more research you do, the better informed you'll be along your journey, and the better off our planet will be.